Hello, my name is Indrajit and I live at the foothill of the Mount Kinnai. You might be listening to my spiritual videos, my political analysis video, my electronics video, radios, but what I am presenting you has arose from the Twitter, that toolkit case, but it is an old hidden secret. So I'm opening it for you. Understand it and use it. It is called toolkit. It has nothing to do with the traditional meaning of the word toolkit. So enjoy my toolkit, and it has the seed, how to make a toolkit and what effect it will be and how to destroy the toolkit. So all in one. Toolkit, making of toolkit. What is a toolkit? Bunch of instruments put into a box for doing a mechanical, electrical, carpentry, weaving, masonry or any other repairs and handy instruments related to it. Roughly spoken, it is a root, idea, seed. Put concisely in few words, it is seed which germinates with right people who give time, care and result manifestation will be the idea depicted, desired in that seed. Alexander, Ashok, Chinese Empire, Dharmanist Hindus, Shivaji Maharaj, Savarkar, etc. had dream of winning this ancient land for different toolkits. Latest retainer were Britishers. A camel driver had dreamt of gifting India to a kid oblique girl. Toolkit will be looking innocent on face value. The way it is implemented makes the difference. Examine toolkit's harm, the end result, how it affects your interest. Say we will have Janoi. It's a simple cotton thread, but it makes groups, those who wear it, ours, and those who are forbidden to wear, others. Every toolkit to succeed needs two parties, ours and theirs. Sometimes it has neutrals also, enemies, conflict, or sometimes in a cohesive group, difference is created in order to create way for toolkit. All these toolkits looks for benefit to our and the loss of others. Wearing an identifier turban with special colors, different method of wearing it, Gandhi topi, skull cap, etc. are part of toolkit to force people into visible dichotomy of two, ours, others, friends, enemies. First stage of toolkit process creates a unique bunch of people who interpret the seed sentence and tries to propagate and implement. This implementation is very slow due to inherent newness of the idea. The implementing peoples are well known in society, have social authority, time, resource, and aim to gain something from it, so much motivated to sacrifice everything for this cause. After this, few people can accept and understand it, and these few people start to propagate. They are influencers. With time, idea becomes accessible to more people, and loads of words are added, methods thought about, resources come after people start joining. Say, if one day His Holiness Shankaracharya Bhagwan says Every Sanatani Grihastha has to have weapon of God, that is Trishula, on his body, home, place, as mandatory dharmic ritual expression. Some people will have small 1-inch gold-plated trishul to wear in neck chains. Some will have 1-foot metal trishul at home, in vehicle, or some will have full-fledged 4-foot ones. This generates an industry of trishul making, and within a generation it becomes identifier and will result in making a dharmic martial race. Creation of Janak Kshatriya. Akharas were result of His Holiness Shankaracharya Bhagwan's mandate to sannyasi. Recently, some famous toolkits are Sarva Dharma Sadbhav of Congress, Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas of BJP, Corruption Free India, AAP. This means nothing. It's a toolkit for getting what and coming to the power. Toolkits have different result, and we gullible peoples are the sufferers, because it's fantasy of one person. One to many is nature, and it generates itself, propagates itself. If mechanism is right and able to give benefits to propagators, influencers, and people following it, and put disadvantage to those who does not follow it. How you kill an idea? It's immortal. Its seeds remains dormant, and then with right environment, willing peoples, it regenerates. You need counter toolkit to eradicate people's following first toolkit. If both continues, one set of people will fatigue you and collapse. In short term, you have to eliminate the seeds implanted in people through educating them. Seed is anti-humanity, or putting them in so much disadvantage, pain, that they themselves abandon it. Making alternate system where this toolkit create a system becomes weak, uneconomical, and people willingly give it up, but does not always succeed. Sure short method is removing peoples by eliminations, exodus, or implanting new people. The state is always a big enemy or killer of toolkits, toolkit makers, because it has means, resource to enforce its will by force. Does the state, those in power, have will to ban toolkits? Well-designed toolkit can eat up state and itself become state. A famous example is CCCP. How to implement the seed idea to people in first generation is a tough task. For getting right people, someone needs to give up his or her time to find them or make them. This is my toolkit to understand the toolkit methodology and thus eradicate those 2000, 14,000, 7 years lies imposed upon us and suffering caused to us. Toolkit always make difference. It guards and create a group united for a purpose. It cuts the big group and creates a small united group. Mutual benefit networks. Vishwame Shanti Ho is not a toolkit because it cannot be implemented. Toolkit inherently creates group division, its small united entity against big entity. Vasudeva Kutumbakam, Vishwame Shanti Ho groups are associated to Sar Tanse Juda group, as it inhibits Dharmanishtha for Dharmic Rashtra and Sivka Sasan concept. Can we write in better words? Yes, go ahead. That's how toolkits grows. But root has to remain same. Not every well-written document showing new ideas are toolkit. The aim should be worldly one, implementable, and should create conflict. Generation of conflicts is a must, as conflict benefits are its main driving engine. In the end of war, there is bloodshed, victory, wealth. Summarize toolkit. There is a situation, an opening. You see it, and then to capture it, idea arise. You try to implement it. Resources generated. Then it is given a time to germinate. More people joins. Conflict arise, and end result of toolkit, whatever it was meant for or dreamed of. Commonly, people are motivated by simple things: money value, words, kind words, foods, meats, taste. It helps. Material benefits, threats. Some people need care. Benefits of joining the toolkit gang, and security and warmth of the group. So this is the way people are motivated. So in this toolkit, you need people and idea to plant into the people's brain. So that's it.